really close run thing so far.
It has. Could have been all different yesterday. Let's not forget that Ronnie led 5-1. But how well did Gary do to come back into the session 5-4? And you can't discount this man against Ronnie this afternoon. You know, you, Ronnie friend. Knows he's got to play well.
Gary Wilson's a break.
This could be one to savour.
Three straight frames from the underdog. Can he make it four and tie this match at five apiece? It's worth noting, and we've already mentioned, Mike, that he made eight centuries in qualifying, including the max. But the next best in terms of century makers in qualifying at Ponds Forge was three centuries. So that just shows how well he scored in those three qualifying rounds.
Just saw the pot success there. Yeah, 91 and 87. That's got to go up for Gary, of course. I mean, he's back in this, but he needs to get that percentage up. It's a good test for him this afternoon. And also, you know, so often the case, sometimes we wonder what sort of which Ronnie's going to turn up. We shall see this afternoon. If he plays, Ronnie plays, and obviously he's a very, very strong favourite. But...
yeah, well, just the one 50-plus break from Gary Wilson, as you see there. O'Sullivan making a 1-2-2 and four other contributions in excess of 50. O'Sullivan always scores heavily, win or lose. But the pressure is on this guy this afternoon, the Rocket. He's expected to win, of course. Mm. And that creates its own pressure.
Yeah, good shot there from Gary. I don't think he actually went for the pot there. I think he meant to push it towards the middle, but cover it as well. So a little clip of Ronnie practicing earlier today, Phil, didn't we, with his great friend Damien Hirst.
Yeah, it's not bad when you can get a billionaire to pick the balls out of the pockets for you. Well,
absolutely.
He might not quite be a billionaire, but he's not far off it, Damien.
I wonder how much he's charging Ronnie for that. Yeah, great friends. I'm sure that Damien is in the audience somewhere today. The problem, of course, here is the red near the middle pocket. But if this guy can get capture this opening frame, make it five apiece, you never know. Could be a very interesting afternoon. Well, I suggest this might be going towards a re-rack, especially with that red there. And yeah, don't be surprised if it's called in a few shots' time.
Referee, I'm sure, won't hang about if he feels as though the frame can't be progressed, and sure enough, there's already been agreement to start again.
Yeah, Ronnie's also the same. He doesn't like tip-tapping around like that, Phil, does he? So come on, let's just set them up. Let's get on with it.
Just their second meeting, their first earlier this year in Berlin, German Masters, and it was a tight one. O'Sullivan won, but only 5-3. Crucible Theatre, looking forward to another afternoon of terrific snooker. Of course, keep you in touch with developments on the other table. Bingham and Ebden just getting underway.
Just look at some of the prize money here, Phil. Ronnie O'Sullivan just under, I think, might have just gone over actually, the £9 million mark on the table, and 2.4 of that has come from here at the Crucible Theatre.
Won his first world title in 2001, his most recent back in 2013. Ronnie O'Sullivan, as Wilson watches on. And it's the longevity at the top that Ronnie O'Sullivan has produced, which is perhaps the most impressive aspect of his extraordinary career. Brilliant as they were, Steve Davis and Stephen Hendry had their success largely condensed to a single decade. And they had an awful lot of it. But O'Sullivan has been able to stay at the top for way longer.
And I think also, I'll just let Gary play this shot under the left eye striking, of course. Very similar to Graham Miles was the same. Hang on, that's a bonus.
I was about to say, we could look at John Higgins as well, Phil. You know, he's playing some great snooker as well. And he's thinking, he was looking at Ronnie O'Sullivan a couple of years ago. He's thinking, well, if he can do it at 38, 39, why can't I? And it's sort of, John Higgins has got like his second wind.
Yeah, two big titles for the Wizard this season, including, of course, the Champion of Champions, which he won at the expense of O'Sullivan. Higgins underway tomorrow afternoon, by the way, against Martin Gould, and that's going to be a tough one. Gould is a very difficult draw for anyone.
Four.
Came through qualifying Martin. Of course, he won the German Masters last season. His maiden ranking title. That's a really tough obstacle for Higgins first up. But back here, Gary Wilson first in our first frame.
Five.
I think he's missed that. Oh, just thought it looked a little bit wide when it started out. It was only the pace.
12.
Looks fairly calm.
I think he was really relishing the opportunity to take on O'Sullivan. Clearly, he could scarcely have had a tougher draw, having come through qualifying.
13.
But on the eve of the championship, when, of course, we had our special 40-year anniversary here at the Crucible, he was asked by the BBC's Hazel Irvin how he felt about his first round opponent, and he was very much looking forward to it. I think he sees it as a privilege, the opportunity to play one of the all-time greats here.
Well, that's the attitude you've got to have. He's done the hard work to get here. Let's see how far you can go.
Well, that's a pretty decent split. Remember, this break was launched by a fluke. Can he make the most of it?
And we saw what happened last year with Ding Junhui coming through those qualifiers, Phil. We keep saying it, you know, the match fit. Steve Maguire's beaten a seed, Anthony McGill. You know, he was pretty sharp. Ronnie's coming in 21. Cold, as all the seeded players are. And I think they've got it right, because I remember used to play the qualifiers of the World Championship in September, the year before the actual event. That was ridiculous. But now, a few days before the Crucible, they've got it spot on.
Well, it adds to the drama, apart from anything else, doesn't it, with the qualifying rounds so close to the event. Just heightens the anticipation and the expectation.
Well, you know, you do the hard work during the season, like Ryan Day got in, you know, Mike Williams had won in China, he would have been here on the 16th, in the top 16. That's the reward for being here. But you know that you can get a bit sticky against a qualifier who's match fit.
Yes, ironically, Williams provisionally is now back in the 16, but of course it came too late for him, having just missed out by not winning the China Open against Selby. Pushed Selby close in the final, but then lost to Stuart Carrington in qualifying. But now provisionally, because of course points are coming off, there's a two-year 35. Cycle as regards the rankings, he's back up there. Well, you said it, Mike. He looks pretty calm, cool and collected, doesn't he? 68 points.
43.
Is what he's looking for here, assuming he continues to take blacks. And it will be looking like five apiece from 5-1 down. Not often that O'Sullivan loses four frames on the bounce to anyone, although 44. He did lose 4-3 from 3-0 up earlier this season to Mark Davis, who didn't make it through qualifying.
Well, that's not quite a plant. They could go into them gently here and just nudge it towards the corner. Not too much pace. Just got to be careful, hit that red bang on the nose on the pink spot. Always come off them. We know that the white always travels towards the corners. Well, he's got one to the centre here, which is tough.
50.
He's got a 50-point lead. I mean, he should close the shot.
Yes, discretion, the better part of valour, surely, in this situation.
no point taking anything on risky, is there? What's the point in that? I think he's trying to cut this one back near the black. Send the white down the table for safety. If he goes in, he's got control of the table once more. He's missed it, though, and he might have left it. Well, I think he's okay. I think he's got the cover with the brown. But a good start here for Gary Wilson in this opening frame of the second session.
Excuse me. Just hang on a sec, Ronnie. Come down.
I think someone has said something they shouldn't have there. I'm not quite sure what it was, but you saw the reaction of both O'Sullivan and referee Brendan Moore, and I think he's seen his last snooker at this year's tournament. This one
here. Yeah, he needs to go.
Unnecessary, and the last thing we need, frankly. There's enough drama on the table without any required in the audience. So a slight hiatus while that gentleman is extricated. Early stages of the first frame on the other table, of course. Stuart Bingham with a 5-point lead over Peter Ebdon in frame one. And we're ready to go again.
Well, you can see that he has covered this red, but Ronnie playing the swerve here. He could easily pot this. Nope, caught the wrong side. Trying to get it safe, though. Oh, would you believe he could go past that red? Well, that's going back, I think. Unless Gary decides to move the red away. Just look at this. I can't believe there's room past that red. Oh. He could play away, move the red away from the pocket, actually, because if he puts Ronnie back, he could possibly pot it. Oh, well, there you go. Well, I think the white is a little bit more to the right as we look, actually, because, yeah, it needs to go probably an inch to the right. It wasn't that much, because Ronnie was coming the other side, I think.
Yeah, it's quite a bit wide of the mark at the moment. It needs to go as we look to the right.
He swerved around the right-hand side of the brown, Phil, not the left, so it's got to go,
That's
it's coming,
like it.
Coming around the right-hand side of the brown.
This is where the still frame is handy, and I think that's about right.
Yeah, within the circle, Ronnie. Okay.
All done. He'll be playing the same shot again. Okay, too thin. Not bad.
Yes, I think he'll take that. Wilson has a 54-point lead, but if O'Sullivan can get back in, every chance he could pinch this frame.
Mobile phone went off there. Got to make sure that switched off. Good pace on the white here from Gary. Just got to keep the pressure on Ronnie in this opening frame of the session. Make it five apiece. Don't take any undue risks. This man has to do that to get himself back into this frame.
It's been a very consistent season for Ronnie O'Sullivan. Three major finals and, of course, the Masters title. But he lost the ranking finals. And the last one that he won was the 2016 Welsh Open, so he'll feel as though he's due another big ranking title, and none bigger than this one. It's funny, isn't it, Mike? by O'Sullivan standards, he'd probably feel a little bit frustrated at the way things have gone this season because he hasn't landed a ranking title. Then you look at the prize money he's trousered, £420,000.
Yeah, absolutely. I'll tell you what, though, he'd love to capture this one for the sixth time, wouldn't he? Don't worry, underneath, he'll be trying like a bear.
And that's something that cannot be doubted. He has given it absolutely everything in every match he's played this season, win or lose.
And he promised to play in more events this year, and he has done. But this is the real deal. This is the one he wants. He's done it five times before, of course.
The winner, remember, plays either Sean Murphy or Yan Bingtao, with Murphy having finished their session earlier today with a 6-3 lead. Sullivan likes Selby in the top half of the draw, so they could potentially meet in the semi-finals, but there's a lot of snooker to be played before then.
Very close to that ground. Oh, well, Gary. Chance for Ronnie here to get right back into this frame. Won't be best pleased with that one.
Hit it almost full in the face here.
One.
I can tell you that Stuart Bingham's on the cusp of taking the opener against Peter Ebdon.
There's a bit to do here for Ronnie, but he's in with a chance. A couple of cannons and got these reds open. The sort of the colours and potable positions.
Nine.
Now, will he drift into the two reds here or screw into the three? Might be the three reds. Well, he's gone for the other two. Well, he's just caught them a little bit thinner than intended. That's not, he won't be best pleased with that one.
16.
And the expression confirms as much. Not the cannon he was hoping for.
No, he was looking for about quarter ball actually. Still plenty on for him, though.
16.
Look at this one.
Huh. Well, it's an area of O'Sullivan's game that tends to go unnoticed at times because of the quality of his break building, but as a safety player, he's right up there with the best, and I'm sure his association with Ray Ridden back in the middle 90s, or rather the middle noughties, I should say, when he won his second world title, was instrumental in strengthening that side of his game. Reardon has actually said that he helped Ronnie to learn to love the defensive side of things, because previously he was very much about all-out attack.
Yes, and Ray also said that Ronnie was a very good listener.
They had a great rapport and they're still very close friends. Reardon, of course, who won this title for the very first time at the Crucible. First ever winner. Six times in all, a champion Reardon, one of the greats, unquestionably. One. Steve Davis's idol growing up. And many others, I'm sure. But this is another decent chance for O'Sullivan to get right back into this first frame of the final session.
Seven. Eight.
Spot the deliberate mistake. Of course, it was John Spencer who won the first one, wasn't it? Cliff Thorburn was his victim, I believe.
Yep, think so.
15.
Cliff went on to win it in 80. Reardon won it in 78.
60.
The last of his six titles. Griffiths, 79. And Davis, the first of his six in 81. What a rich history this great venue
22.
Possesses.
23.
This time I ever saw the World Championship, Phil, was back in 76. It was at Withenshaw Forum in Manchester. And Ray Reardon beat 29. Alex Higgins there. Played really well. And then I went to the Crucible Theatre in 77 for the first time. Loved it.
30.
Yes, Mike Watterson, snooker promoter, was the man who brought this tournament to the Crucible. But it was actually his wife, Carol, who recommended the venue. And my goodness, how inspired was that decision?
Ronnie here then dropping behind this final red, just eight points behind. Well, they're all there, and I'll tell you what, this will be a bit of a blow here to Gary Wilson if he loses his frame, because the start that he made in it, and he could have tightened things up, and he missed a couple of chances, and he could easily lose it from here now.
Running on the stretch rather here, but that was beautifully cued.
38.
So scores level.
He's gone too far, I think, Phil. The green won't pass the yellow. He's played on the yellow. It won't go, so that could be end of break. Just dropping behind the green for the snooker. You're going to have to wait for another chance.
Ronnie O'Sullivan, 38.
Well, 38, but he wanted to be on the yellow there.
Yeah, you saw that little shake of the head from O'Sullivan. He expected to polish off the frame there, as it is. Scores level with the colours remaining.
Just bounced the cue ball into the cushion there to get the angle. He nearly popped the yellow in the middle. It would have been nicer on the green as well. So, which way is this opening frame of this final session then, or second session, going to go?
The opening frame of the deciding session on a knife edge.
The blue is a good target to get in behind. Not this time. I wonder if Gary will take this on. Could probably play up and down with the yellow. Just wait. Could have easily lost his frame a couple of minutes ago if Ronnie had landed on that yellow. Yeah, I think that was the right shot to play at this stage of the frame. It's all the fives and the fours, Phil.
Yes, a certain symmetry to the scoreboard. O'Sullivan now in his 42nd year, but still in terrific shape, physically and, of course, mentally these days. Said ahead of this tournament that he enjoys it more than ever now, because whereas in the past, and he's played one there, hasn't he? He was up and down. Now he's much more on an even keel and can enjoy it more as a result.
And this is tough to hit. It's going to come off this left-hand cushion with a lot of side here. Just look at this, worth the replay. As long as he avoided the double kiss, we knew what was coming. Brilliant.
Foul on the miss. Ronnie O'Sullivan, 6.
Well, I think that's going back.
Okay, a little bit that way.
It's very difficult to get anywhere near this yellow. The brown is in the way as well. If it wasn't there, if it's on its spot, it'd be much easier. But he's got to try and manufacture an angle. I'm not sure going this way that it's on. Nope, pink again. Guess what?
No miss.
That's going back. Could be a free ball, this.
Ronnie O'Sullivan, 6. Free ball.
Not sure that's going to change anything. No, back it goes. Handy points here, though, for O'Sullivan.
Move the yellow about there. Just a fraction there, yeah.
Yep, Ronnie will just stay in his chair, take the points. Again, I'm not sure that he's on from this angle. Nope.
Foul and a miss.
Guess what?
Ronnie O'Sullivan, 6. Free ball.
Well, he's got to be careful here, Wilson, because these points are mounting, and as you can see, only 27 on the table, obviously, 18 behind now.
Well, imagine if he hits the pink another couple of times. He'll need a snooker. Nope, I don't think it's on. Oh, dear me, now then, there's a difference. Well, I don't know whether Ronnie will put it back this time.
Okay, so 24 the difference. He only needs the yellow.
Yeah, good spot, Phil. Oh, this has been a disaster. He had a great start to the frame. Towards the end of the frame, it's been a total disaster for Gary Wilson.
But what a terrific snooker that Ronnie O'Sullivan laid. It's one in the frame, surely. It was very tough for Wilson to find a way out of it. So it's looking like O'Sullivan, from more than 50 points adrift, is going to win this opening frame and move two clear again.
Yeah, just not this green as well. Don't worry about the brown, of course. The green to really make sure. Oh, well, there's a little bit of light at the end of the tunnel here.
Two.
The difference is 26. There are 25 there.
Should be over now, either to the middle or to the corner. Well, this could be massive, Phil, in the context of the match, because we know it should have been 5-all. We think it's about to go 6-4, and we know what Ronnie's like as a front runner. He could be off into the distance.
It's a blow, certainly, for Wilson, who had that very healthy lead. Had a chance to get back in, missed a long red.
Ronnie O'Sullivan, 3.
So 29 now the difference. He needs a couple of snookers.
Yeah, and you can't blame him for playing on here. This is a big, big frame.
Brown.
Yeah, so Ronnie's just asking for the brown to be clean. He had actually got a kick on his last shot.
Get the white cleaned. No, I thought he was going to get the white cleaned as well.
He could be in trouble here behind the black or the pink. Well, he should have been. Well, that's not clever. You won't miss this. It's about to go 6-4, and it could have been 5 apiece. Well, didn't expect that. Well, it's over now. Well, Gary doing the gentlemanly thing there, allowing Ronnie to win the frame on his shot. But he'll be disappointed that he's lost this opening frame, considering the start he made.
4.
Yes, Wilson had a 50-point lead. And he had one or two other chances later in the frame. But it was the brilliant snooker that Ronnie O'Sullivan laid, which was the pivotal moment in this frame. Well,
Ronnie O'Sullivan, 4.
Gary Wilson comes back to the table. Tall order now, to put it mildly. particularly now he's potted the blue, which he didn't have much opportunity to keep out of the pocket, to be fair.
Well, the black is in a good position, but it's a long way back. I don't think Ronnie can pot this. He can see it, but I'm not sure if he can pot it to the middle. Oh, he could even try to, well, he tried to the corner, so he could see more of the pink than I thought.
Wilson requires three snookers here with just pink and black remaining.
No, it's not going to happen. Can't see it happening. Ronnie's too cute for that. Perhaps against a rookie in the qualifiers. Not on this stage.
Unorthodox. So it's Ronnie O'Sullivan who takes the opening frame, and it was the snooker he laid that made the difference there. O'Sullivan extends his lead and moves to within four of victory.
Keep the noise down, please.
He's leading Gary Wilson by 6-4.
I think here, though, Phil, I think you've got to say that this is a must-win frame for Gary Wilson if he's got any chance of winning this match. He's played a good safety here, but if he goes 7-4 behind, look at this, played one. If he goes 7-4 behind, it's going to get sticky for him. So, but if he can put this on the board, you know, he's back in this. It's a long way to go, number 10, but like I said, Ronnie puts two quick frames together here, and then that's tough. Well, it was Ronnie's great snooker that won in the last frame. Now, can Gary take advantage here? Here's his excellent safety snooker behind the green that's given him this chance. Let's not forget, yesterday he was 5-1 down, came back to 5-4.
One.
He can do it again.
He's already proved his resilience, hasn't he? Terrific win over Michael White in qualifying. Comprehensive one as well, 10-3.
Yeah, Michael's no slouch and he's been playing well of late. I think he's just got there. Yep, on this left hand red.
Six.
It's a gimme though.
Made it look easy.
Seven.
Nice angle. Doesn't have to go full-blooded into the pack here. He can just come off the left-hand side and that open red will push it towards the corner. So a gentle cannon, just nudge the left-hand side of the pack. Could go in full to the pink. Doesn't have to. Just a nice, soft, accurate cannon here. Well, downward striking. I think he's going in full-blooded. Oh. Caught them well, could have been better.
Well, he's very unlucky there. If he's not landed on anything, he couldn't have hit that much better than he did.
12.
Super attacking shot, just off the apex of the pink.
Just wonder if there's one to the right centre, Phil, and he can come back for the black. Yeah, I think he's okay, actually. Worked out okay. Wow, what a chance this is.
13.
Former world under 21 champion, Gary Wilson. Made a living as a taxi driver, of course, in years gone by. But he's 20. Discovered that he's a rather handy snooker player.
Well, the meter's running here.
Number of tournaments and the prize money available 21. These days. Wilson, who's still only 31, Could make hay over the next decade.
Doesn't need any direction around the snooker table either.
And this is already a good response to losing the opening frame.
28.
Because he was well ahead in that one and it could have demoralised him. But he's got straight back on with the job here.
Yes, this is not landed ideally. He's going to pot this and just run off another red here. Unless he's going through the gap for the blue. But he's got the reds open. This is a great chance. 29. Played that well. Just thinking this could be a treat here this afternoon, Phil, and that could be punch and counterpunch. There again is the
34
scoring sidebar. 69 points required. Disappointed 35. To lose the last frame. He's got a chance to do something about it here, though.
Yes, and just send a message to Ronnie O'Sullivan that he's not going anywhere. He's going to give it everything in a bid to cause a big upset. Bingham still 1-0 up on Ebden, by the way, on the other table, although Peter Ebden has a 40-point lead in the second frame.
41.
Ronnie O'Sullivan found himself in trouble at the start of this one. Left Wilson a red, and this is the result.
48.
Well, I did say last frame, 49. Gary looked really relaxed and calm and what have you, and the disappointment, of course, losing the frame, but just capture this one, and I'm sure you'll feel better.
Fifty-seven.
I think his heart missed a beat there.
Do you know, I think he got a slight kick there. He just took it offline nearly enough to rattle it. I think it just was a little bit of a kick. That was as well. That's why he's short on the red.
But this red, 64. And another high-value colour. And it should be one apiece for the afternoon session. And the gap reduced to 6-5. That'll do nicely. And how well has Gary Wilson taken these?
Good response.
It's now his highest break of the match.
Well, the thing is, at the end of the day, Phil, we know he knows how well he's played to get here to the Crucible. We keep talking about it, what, 8 centuries, including a maximum. He knows he's playing well. He knows he's playing the most talented, gifted player we've ever seen. But, you know, don't get here and think, well, I'm not going to play, because he knows he's in good form.
Yes, in the past, I think Ronnie O'Sullivan has beaten a lot of opponents before they shook hands at the start of the first frame. His reputation going before him, but I think for Wilson, he was going to always embrace this opportunity, relish the challenge of taking 79. On one of the best ever. And he's giving O'Sullivan quite a match here.
And this has been a superb break. Really has. Not really in any trouble. As soon as he went into the pack, split them, yes, he managed to finish on the one to the middle. But since then, he's been in full 86. Control. Would be nice to see a century.
Would be the 18th of the season for him. Bear in mind, he made just 3 last season. Currently at 59 in the world. He has been as high as 32. That was back in 2015. But he's back on the rise again.
That was clever. Just clipping the other red, bringing it into the open.
87.
What a special moment this will be for Gary Wilson. The first Crucible century on his debut.
93. Well, he could set the high break here. Ronnie's got it at 122. That won't stand. There's 135 on. I don't think that will stand, but yeah.
Well played. 100. Terrific stuff. A great response to losing the first frame, which he looked like winning. And showing that mentally he is rock solid. And Ronnie O'Sullivan still has plenty to do to win this first round match. A century from the debutant as he closes the gap to 6 frames to 5. Of the qualifier, but he's got plenty still to do to get the win that's expected of him. Well, you saw from his reaction he wasn't thrilled with that safety. You know, a little bit lucky there, could have left that red.
Well, we think this is a marathon, Phil, 17 days. Just looking through the lists, and back in, like, 1947, 48, 49, there was 82-63 to Walter Donaldson against Fred Davis. Fred Davis won it that year, 84-61. And the next match was 80-65. You'll notice on a challenge basis then, rather than a championship basis, but that's amazing, isn't it?
Yeah, and back then, they used to play the dead frames. So even once someone had got to the winning line and couldn't be caught, they'd play the remaining frames just for fun.
Imagine Ronnie having to do that now. He'd be walking out, wouldn't he?
I was going to say, I don't think he would have particularly enjoyed that.
No, sorry, I'm off home. I'll see you in a couple of days.
Wow, that was an ambitious attempt on the red. I guess he felt as though it was worth the risk because he wasn't leaving much.
Cagey start then, to the start of this 12th frame. Gary, just looking at this loose red on the right hand side of the pack. It's dangerous. Great century in the last frame to claw one back. Can he draw level? I think he's going to put the white to the top cushion here. Oh, well, is he? Is he going for this? Well, at least he managed to avoid things at this end. Well, I thought he might have a go at that one, chose not to. They've got the double kiss, and if Ronnie can pop this one in, it could be costly.
Having got the double kiss, Wilson's a little bit lucky that he's not left something easier for O'Sullivan. This is not a straightforward red by any means.
I think he'll be going for it then.
Well played.
Yeah, that was a loose one from Gary there. Might pay the price. Especially what he's just done in the last frame with that century. You know, don't do that and then just gift the next one away. That was still a good pot though, and it was clean.
Six.
Well, if the red knows the black goes to the left corner, he'll be playing that way, but he might come down the left-hand side. Nope, gone the other way. Obviously goes.
Twelfth.
O'Sullivan making his 25th Crucible appearance.
13.
Just done through the gap here, leave himself on the red to the right corner pocket. Well, decided to drop it in.
The applause is for a steal from Stuart Bingham. I think it may have been a black ball game. 20. And he's doubled his lead over Peter Ebden after a lengthy second frame. So 2-0 Bingham.
21.
Just stunned off the edge of the pack there to open them up. Could have, well, he wanted to be a little bit further down, of course, but now will he take the blue to the middle or the corner? Possibly the middle.
20.
Oh, and here's a bit of luck here. Not as planned.
26.
Not happy. We know that Ronnie's a perfectionist, and that's not one of his best. Still might take this red onto the yellow pocket.
's a great pot.
Well, I mean, what can you say, Phil? He just stroked it in, didn't he? Did nonchalant, you know, brilliant.
As soon as he hit it, he knew that was in. He made a difficult shot look easy. And how often has he done that in his career?
Stop counting.
And this, of course, is where O'Sullivan can be deadly when he's in amongst the reds like this. At close quarters,
29.
No one better in the history of the game.
Yeah, he would have preferred to have been on the straighter red there to be on the black. No problem, though.
30.
our prime position.
36.
Well, this is a replay of what was, trust us, a very difficult red. Beautiful touch.
45.
Once again, our trusty sidebar tells us that O'Sullivan is very close to making it 7-5. Just 75 on the table. And it was the error with the safety from Gary Wilson that led O'Sullivan in.
60.
For what looks like being a winning contribution.
61.
Well, it could be back-to-back centuries here, one from either player. It's warming up nicely, Phil.
Yeah, we only had one century on the first day. That was from Rocket Ronnie, 122. 67. Today, we've already had at least five.
68.
And you won't get very good odds on a six being made
75.
Just the 869 82. For the career. 45 82. Of them this season.
89. I was hoping to nudge that red into a better position.
90.
Well, it's all about that final red now, if he makes the century or not. I think he's got the angle just to get him behind it. He's gone to move it. Oh, I think it goes.
94. Proud willing O'Sullivan to make the ton here.
Well, we talk about this word genius. It's bandied around, Phil. This guy is a genius, isn't he?
With a capital G.
'97.
Yellow and green needed. Well, this is great stuff. I mean, 99. You know, Gary made the ton 100 exactly in the last frame. 'Ve had a terrible day today, Phil, haven't we? Really poor, isn't it?
A slab of the old O'Sullivan magic on show here.
106.
He hasn't been at his brilliant best this season, and yet he still had a season that 99% of the pros would very gleefully take.
170.
But this is the Rocket at his quite brilliant best. A quite magnificent 124 clearance from Ronnie O'Sullivan in response to the century from his opponent in the previous frame. And he's two clear again at 7-5. Ronnie O'Sullivan returns from a comfort break.
Frame
we saw the very best of Ronnie in the previous frame, a quite magnificent 124 clearance to re-establish control in this first round match. 7-5, he leads Gary Wilson, three away from victory.
Yeah, it's an interval to come after this one as well. There's a little tempter here for Gary on the right-hand side. Came across it. Just depends where they finish. Not bad.
He's certainly taken the game to O'Sullivan in this match. He's not been in any way intimidated. He's played his own game, gone for his shots.
Yeah. Why not? Got a game plan, but this one's on. We saw earlier in the day, Sean Murphy knocked the one of these and screwed back to the side cushion. That was incredible. Oh, hello. Hello. Has the switch been flicked?
Yes, you just sense that O'Sullivan is ready to move through the gears as only he can. Couldn't have cued that any better.
You can see the focus in him, Phil, can't you? His concentration is there, it's better.
Well, I think O'Sullivan still believes, and why not, that if he can play his best, he remains the best.
Seven.
There are so many terrific players out there, and he's not been the best this season, but we know that his A game is capable of touching previously unknown heights. The question is whether he can do it for the full 17 days.
Eight.
Sullivan, like Selby, defending champion, is in the top half of the draw. They could meet in the semi-finals. That one only just dropped. Looked as though it might draw, actually, but in it goes. And if O'Sullivan does come through, he'll be back in action on Thursday for 50. His second round match. Murphy or Bing Tao will be his opponent. Should he do the business this afternoon?
16.
Just wanted that white to be a fraction higher. He can get the pack here. He can clip him on the left-hand side of the pink. Ooh, not bad. Just a little bit concerned when that red went towards the middle, but he's got them. He's got into a different gear here, Phil, hasn't he?
It's so noticeable, isn't it, the way he's just suddenly, from nowhere really, stepped it up. And perhaps that century from Gary Wilson has inspired him.
Yeah. Just class. Pure class.
Stuart Bingham, I can tell you, has made another sizeable break to make it 3-0 now against Peter Ebden on the neighbouring table. That second frame was a big one because Ebden was well in front. Bingham stole it.
24.
Might just get rid of that one near the green and then sort of concentrate things at this end. This could be 8-5. And the way he's queuing now, I think it might be.
Yes, 29.
Gary Wilson might find himself running through the curtain to the mid-session interval because he'll be more 30. Than happy to see O'Sullivan stopped in his tracks. Ronnie, I'm sure, would want to stay out there now. He's on a roll. 35. So often we see that interval change things around. The momentum can shift. 93% is very good. That was a kick.
Oh, well, he's still got a pot on the pink, but he wanted to be further down. Oh.
Cue ball stopped in its tracks by the bad contact.
Yeah, but there is a pot on.
There's Damien Hirst. He's only just released a brand new collection, I believe, in Italy. It's a mixed reviews, but he does tend to polarise opinion, does Damien?
42.
I wouldn't mind being a dollar behind him, or even five.
43. That's a bonus with the pink going there because the black might have been tough. He might take the pink now. got to avoid the balk colours, though. It's difficult to get onto a red. I mean, the black would be tough. I'm sure he's going to take the pink. It's guaranteed, really. Ooh, this looks good. This looks very good. Oh, what can you say? Oh, frame over.
Well, chalk that up as a potential shot of the championship. I'm sure it'll make the shortlist. My goodness me, what a shot that was.
We've said it many times before as we watched the replay. He couldn't hit those reds any better. Bang in the middle. But when he's in this form, Phil, you're a passenger, aren't you?
Well, just when perhaps you begin to wonder whether O'Sullivan has peaked and there's just a marginal decline in his game, he suddenly produces a couple of frames like he has here. And makes a mockery of that thinking.
This is a tough game.
Believe it or not.
But he makes it look ridiculously easy, doesn't he? Well, Gary can do nothing about this if it's one visit stuff.
Well, the worst thing Gary Wilson has done, arguably, is make that century because it's just inspired O'Sullivan to hit new heights.
Yeah, don't make him angry. I think you're right. Brilliant. Well, not there. It's not there yet, though, in this frame. He's still got a bit to do, but...
Yeah, wrong side of the blue, so... Not quite done and dusted as yet.
Well, from Gary's point of view, the interval couldn't come at a better time. He's got a chance to regroup, because if he stays out there, I think there might have only been sort of 30 minutes left in this match, the way Ronnie's playing at the moment. Could have been bang, bang, two frames gone. Thank you very much. He's got 15 minutes to think about things. 8-5 behind. Ronnie still needs two.
But they're all finding the centre of the pocket now, aren't they? Again, wrong side of the blue for comfort, but he's very close to the winning line here.
Oh, that was played, that was meant. He calculated the angle to run into the red there. 69.
When he first linked up with Roy Reardon and won his second world title, I remember Ronnie O'Sullivan saying that his goal was to make the balls talk. And you kind of get the feeling that they're singing at the moment.
Thanks.
Yeah, unfortunately for Gary, it's not 70. A duet.
Century from Wilson feels like 74. Quite a long time ago now. Got him to within a frame. We're not going to see a second consecutive century from Ronnie O'Sullivan.
74.
But barring snookers, he is going to take an 8-5 interval lead. 74, another sublime break from O'Sullivan, full of terrific shots.
See the annoyance there in Ronnie, because he knows if that red goes in, it's his frame over. You can't, again, blame Gary for coming back here. Gone for the double. Oh, well played. Nicely on the black. Yeah, Ronnie was just a little bit annoyed that he didn't took that frame away at that visit.
Even so, four snookers required as things stand. Tough ask.
Eight.
Where's the chance of a free ball, of course, which would make life easier.
Nine.
Might just run into the red here, just push it on. Well, he's thought about this, Phil, hasn't he? And he's thinking, like, right, look where the red is near the yellow. I'll take these and then lay the snooker from that.
16.
17. Well, that's where he needs to be, beyond the bolt line here, which would be perfect.
18.
Well, this looks very good. Oh, he wants to get past the brown. Oh, that's no good there. had to get past the balk colours.
Well, that's a little bit unlucky, isn't it? A little bit unlucky.
I mean, touching ball would have been handy. Well, that's not bad, but it's fairly easy to hit. I mean, if he goes beyond the yellow, you know, tucked in behind the yellow, absolutely glued to it, then that was tough. But this is pretty easy to hit. Oh, I'm saying it's pretty easy to hit. What about that one?
Well, it's a major surprise because there was a big margin for error there off the ball cushion. Perhaps he was just deliberately trying to hit it thin to get the cue ball back down towards the black and just overcook the angle.
Yeah, Ronnie's not. He doesn't need to be too concerned yet. Because this will be green as the red, high value colour to come. Oh, don't go in off. Don't go in off. Well, he's landed a little bit. he's not in a good place here because he's landed a little bit straight on this black. Now, how can he get anywhere near this red? I mean, he needs the points, ideally. He'd probably be laying a snooker here, but he needs the points.
Yeah, he's got to pot this black to have any chance of turning this frame around.
Eight.
Well, there's not much sticking out there.
38 the difference, 35 on. It's just the one snooker needed now.
Yeah, looking to get him behind the black, I think. Oh, well. Well, hang on, though. He didn't want that in. He didn't play the pot. He's got to pot this colour. Well, he doesn't have to, but... he's got to do something with it. He was playing the snooker. He just caught it too well. He wanted to hit the red thinner. What does he do now? 37 behind. Got to go for this black. Well, if this doesn't go in, of course, it's frame over. Has he got it? Has he got it? I tell you what, he looks good. Oh, what about that? He's still giving himself a chance in this frame. That is brilliant.
Well, Sullivan has to sit and suffer a bit longer.
16.
One snooker required. And what a frame this would be for Gary Wilson to win. Scarcely believable just a few minutes ago that he could have any chance of getting back into it. O'Sullivan with that sublime break of 74 looked certain to go 8-5 in front.
Well, it would be slightly hold the back page, Phil, wasn't it?
16.
When's the last time we saw Ronnie lose a frame from 74 points in the lead?
He's still the favourite, though. No snooker for Wilson.
Yeah, and I think he's left this on. Chose to play the safety. He's prepared to wait. This looks pretty good. Well, we talk about the tactical nous, don't we? Look at that.
Yes, Mr. Reardon would have been proud of that one.
Wonder if he's on commission. Good hit. Well, that was nearly a bonus. Not yet that. Sorry, not there yet. Too thick. Well, it's not finished bad. Only the reason I said that is because he's bringing the yellow at the table. But it's a good cue ball. That's the thing of this game, Phil, isn't it? You just can't let your guard down for a minute, can you?
No, many a frame has been retrieved from this kind of situation.
Well, he was hoping to use the brown as a stopper there, but again, it's finished okay.
O'Sullivan not taking any liberties here. This is the new mature O'Sullivan, who gives every shot its due consideration. Gary Wilson, remember, still needs a snooker to turn this frame around. But it is just the one. Originally it was three.
Well, after all that, I didn't play it really well. Twice across with the yellow, white up and down. If you can avoid the pink, that is, with the yellow. Let's just see which way he goes here. Could go the other way, actually. Yep. Well, that was a good opportunity. It's not an ideal angle on the green here. Just be patient and wait. I mean, the black's in a good spot.
It's all about keeping the object ball safe in this situation, isn't it? Not letting your opponent have a chance to pot it and end the frame. Even if you can't get the snooker.
Good effort, this. Oh, that's no good. Gary, look, he's pushed the black now. He's a million now. Didn't want to contact the black. Well, it's made it slightly easier for Gary with the brown just coming off the cushion, but at least Ronnie's got distance between the green and the others. This is all about Ronnie keeping his discipline, and then it's 8-5 into the interval. Trying to move something. He's done well there. Nicely brought the black into play, but now then, will Ronnie take this on or just wait again? Oh. Great.
There's your answer. End of frame now. A good 15 minutes later than seemed likely when O'Sullivan was closing in on a second straight century. Broke down on 74, but he's produced two outstanding frames here as the Rocket to re-establish firm control of this first round match. Started the afternoon with that narrow 5-4 advantage.
18.
And as they go to the 15-minute mid-session break, he's extended that lead to 8 frames to 5, taking 3 of the first 4 of this concluding session in the process, putting himself within 2 of victory. O'Sullivan leading Gary Wilson by 8 frames to 5.
Quietly as possible, please. Thank you.
But what about this, Phil? He could have taken the black on. He was looking to nudge the pink over the centre pocket, but look at that for a cannon. Incredible, really. Couldn't have hit the pack better than that.
Well, you won't see a better positional shot than that in the 17 days of this championship as Wilson watches on. Let's just have another look at it.
Yeah, there was just a 45-minute spell from Ronnie, isn't he? He was absolutely sublime.
He was. He made a 74 break, and after a protracted safety battle where Wilson tried to get the snookers he needed,
Gary Wilson,
it was O'Sullivan who took the frame to win 3 of the first 4, so he's within 2 of victory. And a meeting with either Sean Murphy or Yan Bing Tao. What's Gary Wilson got left?
Well, for him, I'm sure he was pleased that the interval came, because he might have been sat in his chair a little bit more. But, you know, if he can grab this frame and then go 8-7, who knows? Good break-up shot. But if it goes 9-5, it's just about over, I think.
Well, that is outstanding, isn't it? Oh. This first session of the afternoon, 98% pot success.
Well, I just remember one match, I think it was about 2 years ago, Phil, when Ronnie was like up to 100%, and he finished the match, I think it was at 97%. Incredible.
He certainly turned it on there to give himself this 3-frame cushion.
Yeah, and the thing is as well, like we've been saying in all these matches, these players want to get these out of the way early, don't they? You know, and concentrate on things ahead, the second round, third round, you know, quarterfinals, we should say.
Yes, the Rocket back at the table, assuming he does do the business here on Thursday. Already mentioned that he'll play the Murphy or Yan Bing Tao. Murphy 6-3 up after the morning session today. But Gary Wilson has played exceptionally well.
He has, and he was a passenger for 2.5 frames, wasn't he?
This is his debut, remember. His first taste of competitive action at the Crucible. He's been here as a fan in the past. But he was delighted to draw Ronnie O'Sullivan, not because he felt as though it was a good draw from the point of view of trying to progress, but because he wanted the opportunity to play a player of O'Sullivan's calibre on the biggest stage, and he certainly made a very good fist of it.
And he has, and he wanted to test himself, Guy, didn't he? And he knows, and even if he does lose here this afternoon, he knows that coming into the new season, he knows he can compete at the top level. Well, we've had a re-rack already, and I'm just thinking with the red down the table, we could be heading for another one. There's one down the table, there's one near the middle pocket.
Yes, we started the afternoon with a re-rack, very first frame, just a few shots have been played and they decided to set the balls up again.
Well, Ronnie, we just rolled into the pack here. Nothing much else on. I'd be surprised if he'd play something else. I think it's going to be a re-rack.
Brendan Moore, our referee, normally gives the players 3 or 4 shots apiece to move the frame on. If that doesn't happen, then quick glance between them all and agreement is made to resume proceedings.
Well, won't lose much sleep over this, Phil, will you? And he lives down the road. Well, that's slightly different, because Gary's got the pack covered with the black. Well, that's a possible. Could be touching both reds.
Touching that one and that one, Gary.
Mm. Okay. Well, he's got to find a path here without moving either of these. I think he's okay. Backing behind the black, I think, on the top cushion. Yep, that's okay. Oh, he's caught the knuckle. Well, he's been very lucky to see the cue ball land there. Looking for two more frames to put himself into the last 16. It could be Sean Murphy. 6-3 up from this morning session. Happy. Just waiting for the. So he's still waiting, I should say, for the first red to be potted in this 14th frame. Might be a little tempted here, though, to the middle, to the left middle.
Gary Wilson, who made 5 more centuries than anyone else in qualifying for this event. One of them a maximum. So a very good break builder in his own right. And he's shown some real mettle in this match as well. Remember, he was 5-1 down at one stage, clawed it back to 5-4, and then 6-5 with the century. And it's only some O'Sullivan magic that has seen him fall 3 adrift. And this is a must-win frame, really.
Yes, you would think so. Not quite the snooker.
Another packed house, of course, here. A sellout this event several weeks before we got underway.
Well, a chance for Gary here to come off one of these reds off a cushion and in behind the black. Just depends which way he wants to go. Coming off the right-hand cushion then. didn't need much more. Another inch or so, that would have been perfect. But it's restricted Ronnie's shot choice here. Sounded a bit chunky as well, a bit heavy, but the red's only just gone past the middle pocket. Gary has a chance here of this red on the left-hand side. He can play on the black, but cover the one over the middle with the rest. Got to attack, I think, now. 8-5 behind. 10 minutes gone. First red yet to be potted.
Underway on table two, by the way. Stuart Bingham with that 3-1 lead against Peter Ebdon, former world champions both. Ebdon 43 up in the fifth.
Yeah, but what has Gary done here? I mean, he's expecting to run that red into another one. He's missed everything, come back up the table, and so often we can see this, that finishes up over the middle of pocket. He's given a chance here to Ronnie. If he's got the angle, he can get himself onto the black. This could prove to be expensive. I think he's got a slight angle on this as well. Well, perhaps not. It's dead straight. He can drop it in dead weight for the blue, but he's going across the nap. I think he's got some angle here to come down for the black. Yes. Oh. Well, that is a surprise.
We haven't seen many errors like that from O'Sullivan today.
I'll tell you what, Phil, he didn't want that interval, did he? He was flying. How many times do we see it? You know, the player goes into it, comes off a good run, and then suddenly he's got to regroup and find that form again. Could be playing a double here to the left middle. Well, that was worth taking on. He was always going to cover the one to the right.
Well, has he covered this one, though?
Well, if he hasn't, it's a poor shot.
A rather anxious look from Gary Wilson.
I'll tell you what, you might be right here, Phil. I think you are. Good spot. Well, that was the last thing he wanted to do. But where's this going to finish? He needs a good nudge here. It's okay. Well, a little fortunate. The blue goes.
I've only met once before. Six. That was earlier this year in Berlin, the German Masters. O'Sullivan winning 5-3.
Seven.
Highlight of O'Sullivan's season so far, of course, was the record-breaking seventh Masters title at Alexandra Palace. Runner-up at the UK Championship to Selby. Runner-up in the Champion of Champions to Higgins.
14.
And at the European Masters to Trump.
50.
Well, it's not straightforward from here. These need sorting out. Well, if you need anybody to do it, though, Phil, this is the man, isn't it?
Absolutely.
He just makes he's ridiculously well. He does make it look ridiculously easy, but he's over the years he's just made so many half chances into forwards.
And it was a big mistake, wasn't it, from Gary to leave that red available to O'Sullivan.
Yeah, I had to make sure he covered that one. You know, he had the chance to double the red, and these could have been his himself, but. And the mood that Ronnie's at the moment, you can't see him getting another chance. He's just lost the white there a little bit, though. Might drop this in dead weight for the red left of the pink. He seems to be in the mood, which spells danger for everybody else.
Sullivan's already made two centuries in this match. The 1-2-4 was special this afternoon. Followed it up with 74, which was every bit as good.
Yeah, that's just a little nice purple patch, isn't he? He played on the bottom red here, he's gone too far, but he's got another one. Just got to be careful that he doesn't lose the cue ball. Well played.
39.
Not the perfect angle. Well, I think he was looking to just drift past those two reds and have one into the corner. But it's gone wrong. They both went there. Didn't play the cannon. Looking to put the white on the top cushion.
Ronnie O'Sullivan, 41.
Handy lead then for the Rocket as he looks to move to within one frame of victory.
That's a good shot there from Gary. Took the opportunity to open them up, and he's got the white perfectly behind the black. Again, we talk about the tactical side of Ronnie, Phil. It's the thought process, isn't it? And then it's the execution.
Yes, it was Ray Reardon who helped O'Sullivan learn to love the tactical side of things in the way that he loves attacking and break building and potting. Six times champion Reardon. Second winner here at the Crucible back in 78. Just adding the icing on the cake to O'Sullivan's game and helping him win the second of his five world titles. They're still very close friends.
He's had to run on. Oh, I don't think he's got there. I think Ronnie can pot this. I think this will cut back into the middle. That's another mistake. They're starting to creep in to Gary's game. Call it too thick. Well, could have been better. He's left Ronnie this red to the middle. Got that one. Missed the other one to the other centre. Well, that was a bit of a big bounce there off the cushion. Still on the blue, though.
Seven.
Well, you have to say that ever since Gary Wilson made his excellent century break, his first at the Crucible on his debut, Ronnie O'Sullivan has played a rock solid game, sprinkled with more than a hint of genius. 22. Slightly distracted by some movement in the crowd, but you wouldn't think so to watch him.
He's come round the other end.
Another frame has ended over on table two, and I think it's gone the way of Peter Ebden. It has, so battle well and truly joined over there. Bingham three, Ebden two.
It's because he's come down for the other table. It's because he's come for the other table, but I will tell them. No, I will tell them. Yeah, I will tell them. 28.
Yeah, so somebody just came down the stairs there to go and take the seat to the other table, actually, and just as it was in Ronnie's eye line. And it's quite difficult the way the layout is, the Crucible, the two-table situation, Phil, isn't it?
Yes, all part of the package here at this unique venue, but O'Sullivan well over the winning line in this frame.
But even so, you should always be looking at the players on the other table as well. If they're into, like, the yellow pocket, something like that, then just stand there and wait until you can be behind him, not in front of him. But it doesn't matter. 34. This frame is in the back. It's been an eventful day. One gentleman ejected earlier on the session, wasn't he? He said something. That was it. That was his afternoon done. Sorry.
Yes, he didn't get much value for money from his ticket, did he, given he was ejected just a few minutes into the session. 46. Not sure what he said, but it was obviously serious enough to be shown the door immediately.
47.
Anyway, Ronnie O'Sullivan is moving four up with five to play here, and he's put on an impressive display this afternoon. And there have been suggestions in the quality of his snooker that maybe, just maybe,
51.
There's a sixth world title in him yet.
52.
Finds himself in the unusual position, Mike, of not being the tournament favourite this year. That's held by Mark Selby and Judd Trump jointly.
Yeah, I think Ronnie's third, actually.
56.
Wouldn't be too bothered about that.
58.
This has been very impressive here this afternoon from the Rocket.
124 and 74 before the interval. And another sizeable break here to extend his lead to a near unassailable one.
70.
Easy game, this.
Well, he makes it look so. And that's the real 76. Genius of Ronnie O'Sullivan. There's never been a player quite like him. And you may never see his like again, so enjoy him while you can. Ronnie O'Sullivan moves to within a frame of a place in the last 16 here at the Crucible. He leads Gary Wilson 9-5. Frame, having lost the first three, so two on the spin from Ebden, but Bingham back in with that double.
Yeah, that was terrific.
We'll keep you posted. Back comes O'Sullivan. Can he seal the deal?
Frame 15.
In this 15th play. Be pleased with the quality of his snooker today. Gary Wilson has posed plenty of questions in this match, but O'Sullivan's come up with some pretty impressive answers. And there's an excellent long red from the underdog.
Might not be done yet. It's a long way back from here, though. All you can do is just keep chipping away, see what happens. You could put two quick frames on the board, then it could get interesting.
Terrific queuing, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah. What's that? 10 feet away. Tucked under the back cushion.
Five.
Black was available, had to hold for the pink. This pink might go behind the pack, but if you get on the right hand red, then back for the blue, you could get into the pack. Let's just see where Brendan Moore puts this pink.
No
room on its spot, so in a direct line behind the cluster of reds.
Good angle. 12. Normally we'd be saying going into the pink, but going to the The top red here, same thing. I'm sure he'll go aggressive. Caught them beautifully again. He did that a couple of frames ago. I mean, if you hit that like it has done, the backspin just kills the white. Stays at this end of the table.
The Stephen Hendry special.
Yep. He was the one that introduced that shot. Everybody picked up on it. Same with Cliff Thorburn when he...
18.
The two cushion escape, Phil, isn't it?
Yes, and I would argue that Cliff was the star of the show during the pre-tournament 40th anniversary celebrations here at the Crucible Friday night, recreating the pressure yellow he potted as part of the first ever 147 back in 1983 against Terry Griffiths. He missed it the first couple of times, but I think that was all part of the act.
On purpose. Just teasing the crowd.
He is a real character, is Cliff.
He is.
He was known as the grinder on the table, but away from it, he's one of the funniest guys you could ever meet. Terrific sense of humour. And a terrific player.
Yeah, she certainly earned victories against him. They weren't given.
First overseas winner, of course, the Canadian. But whatever happens from here on in this match, I think Gary Wilson has acquitted himself exceptionally well. He's played some really good stuff.
I wouldn't disagree with that, Phil. And like I said, you know, even if he's on the wrong end of the victory here, then
26.
Just take the positives. Don't take the minuses, you know, the negatives. Just got a season ahead. I mean, it won't be too long for these boys to be back in action after the World Championship, the way the calendar's filling up.
Yes, and all the evidence suggests that we're looking at another late bloomer here. Gary Wilson, 31 years of age. He's been a pro since 2004, but surely playing better now than he ever has. And in qualifying for the Crucible for the first time, it can only give him huge confidence going forward. And as Mike alluded 27. To there, with so much snooker available, so many opportunities to make his mark in the months and years ahead. And who knows, there may be few chapters in this particular tale before the match is done.
He
promised to enjoy himself, faced with what some would regard as a daunting task in taking on O'Sullivan, but he's thoroughly embraced the occasion. He's gone for his shots, he's always looked to attack.
Sixty-three needed.
45.
Stuart Bingham still 3-2 up, by the way, on the other table against Peter Ebden, and 25 points to 1 up in frame 6.
What has he done there? He's tried to hold the white and he's under hit it.
Gary Wilson.
I'm not sure whether he's got away with that. I think there might be a red to the middle. He didn't, he just decelerated with the cue.
That was the problem. Didn't get through the cue ball. He was going so well. It was looking like a frame winning break. He gives very little away, Gary Wilson. He's poker face, but you could just see a trace of a head shake there.
Yeah, and I think he's left this red to the left middle, and I think Ronnie can play a stun into the pink or possibly into the black. Well, he didn't want the red clean. He wanted to push into the black and the red there. That was his intention. Just got too much action on the white.
Philip, if you could just let viewers know that at the end of this match...
Just to let you know that at the conclusion of this match, assuming it ends sooner rather than later, we will be crossing over to the other table and bringing you live coverage of the remainder of the first session of Stuart Bingham and Peter Ebdon. 9 frames to be played, of course, in that first session. They're in the 6th at the moment, so some way to travel in that one. And there could still be some way to travel in this one as well. Wilson 44 in front. Still 67 there, though.
Well, that was a handy little nudge there to open up the pink with Ronnie being 44 points behind. A little bit of insurance for Gary here with the red on the side cushion, but he has to be careful. Caught the second red, but it's not too bad. Well, chose to bring the red off the cushion, but didn't mean to leave the white there. Chance for Guy then to kill off this frame. Nicely done. Shot that well.
That could and should be a frame winner to keep his hopes alive. Slender ones, but while there's life, there's hope.
Eight.
Been around for a while, Guy. Turned professional back in 2004, but I think without a doubt, Phil, this is one of the best performances that he's put in under these circumstances.
Yes, if he can maintain the form he's shown in qualifying for this tournament and indeed against O'Sullivan so far, I think he's set to go a good deal higher than his highest ever ranking, which was 32 a couple 70. Of years ago. He looks like a top 16 player to me. But of course, there are so many players who could lay claim to having that potential.
23.
The strength in depth is extraordinary.
24.
Done enough now in this one.
And to underline that point, Mike, 9 of our qualifiers this year are ranked 40 or below, which I think underlines the strength in depth that we have in the game today. Wilson's one of them, of course.
30.
One of 5 debutants this year. And he's kept his hopes alive. Ronnie O'Sullivan remains the hot favourite to win, but his lead is shaved by a frame. It's now 9-6. In town, just a reminder that earlier today, Murphy took a 6-3 lead, and they resume tomorrow afternoon. So Murphy O'Sullivan still very much on the cards, but not a certainty. Just a reminder that if O'Sullivan does win this frame and with it the match, we will be crossing over to table two to bring you the remainder of the first session between Peter Ebdon and Stuart Bingham. Bingham 3-2 up at the moment. And I can tell you that Stuart Bingham is about to extend his lead to 4-2. There are still three more frames to come in that session, though.
Terrific red from Ronnie there. Didn't quite hide that one with a break-off shot. Yes, he wants this out the way now. Bit of resistance from his opponent in the last frame. I think he's going for the green in the middle and playing on this right-hand red. Oh, unbelievable. Stop it.
Well, Judd Trump likes a bit of naughty snooker. That was pretty naughty.
But nice.
But that wasn't so nice. Ronnie from the sublime to the ordinary. I think that's the difference between the 2017 vintage of Ronnie O'Sullivan, as we see Gary Wilson sink a red there, that there was a time when a miss like that would have driven him insane for a few frames and might have cost him a match. But now he can be philosophical about it. He can shrug his shoulders, pull a funny face and move on. Steve Peters, sports psychiatrist, has a lot to do with O'Sullivan's serene mood these days. And it certainly helped him prolong his career at the top. I'm sure of that. O'Sullivan would be the first to confirm it.
Five.
But Gary Wilson isn't done yet, Mike.
Doesn't look like it. Good response in the last frame. He's going to have a go here. Well, why not?
And at no stage has he looked intimidated or overwhelmed by the occasion. Remember, this is his debut at the Crucible.
Well, what he's played, it's like he's been coming here for 15, 20 years.
He's made a century. He fought back from 5-1 down at the end of the first session to be just 5-4 behind. And this is a pretty decent chance to close to within two at 9-7.
He's also aware that his next mistake could be his last, of course, Gary Wilson, but you can't think about that.
26.
And that's far from ideal.
Yeah, he still has this one to the green pocket, though. Well, we're right behind it. It looks pretty good to me.
87. Terrific pot. He could have left O'Sullivan in if he missed that. He's been a picture of calm, hasn't he, throughout this match?
Do you know, I was just thinking that. You took the words out of my mouth there, Phil. He has. Like I said, it's like a veteran at the Crucible. Oh, hang on. Don't stick on the pink. No, he's okay.
Well, if he can win this frame at this visit, 32. That might just plant a seed of doubt in the Rocket's mind. O'Sullivan did lose this season 33. From three up with four to play against Mark Davis. And he is surely the greatest front runner of all time, Ronnie O'Sullivan. He's made a habit in the past of demolishing opponents, having gained an early lead. Did it to the great Stephen Hendry on a couple of occasions here in semi-finals.
40.
points, assuming he continues with blacks, and Wilson will have won another frame.
41. 48.
Nicely done. Just enough room there. 5 hours now. These two lads have been playing.
56. 57.
57. Well, we had fun this morning, Phil, didn't we, with Sean Murphy, Yang Bing Tao. This has been great as well.
64. 65.
He's not going away.
He is not. He won 3 on the spin yesterday from 5-1 adrift.
73.
He's put together back-to-back frames here to keep his hopes alive. And he's showing Ronnie O'Sullivan that he's not afraid. And certainly not resigned to his fate.
80. 81. 87. 88.
Needs to try and move this red off the side cushion here with the black. Could get him behind it, actually. Might play the cannon, though. Well, once more, Phil, this has been immaculate, hasn't it?
Yes, and I'm sure everyone on this side of the Crucible Theatre is willing Gary Wilson to make his second century of the match here. He deserves it. Frame long since won.
96.
How well has he taken these? What a response to falling 9-5 down. It seemed pretty hopeless at that stage. Rather less so now.
Yeah, terrific. A lot of pride here from Gary Wilson.
98.
And a lot of skill as well. Nothing O'Sullivan can do about this except sit and admire. 100. He's done it to many a player down the years on many occasions, but right now he's having to take some medicine of his own.
Yeah, what a terrific session this has been so far. So Ronnie having to wait for his victory then.
The brown is academic. It's a second century of the match from the Crucible debutant Gary Wilson. And the 31-year-old is not done by any means. O'Sullivan now 9-7 in front.
Eight. It would get really interesting.
Been a terrific match, of that there is no doubt. Two centuries from each player. Lots of other superb breaks along the way, and there's a plant to get Gary Wilson back in again, although no position to go with it.
Gary Wilson won.
Yes, he saw that. They didn't flick off another red.
Sullivan is way too experienced to be panicking. He's still got a two-frame cushion. But he will be mindful that he's got to be careful because Wilson is playing well enough to punish any mistakes. Their only previous meeting at the German Masters this year, O'Sullivan prevailed 5-3. Deep in thought, and he's been given something to think about by his opponent here. Two excellent frames from Wilson to make it rather more interesting.
Might have played the cannon on the red there, the black has missed it, but yep, that's okay, he's on the brown.
Very good pot, given that he's largely sat out the last two frames.
Yeah.
A bit of pressure on him now, Mike.
There is, yeah, but he's got enough to respond, isn't he? But he would have liked to have clipped that red away from the black, though. It would have been bang in there. Could still be. A couple of shots down the road. What a great match this has been.
Five.
Terrific match. The question is how much further we have to go.
Mm.
O'Sullivan obviously wants this done and dusted as quickly as possible now. Because were he to lose this frame, well, then things could get really edgy.
6.
Played that well. This is when his vast experience could well make the difference. He's come through so many close matches in the past here. Lost a few as well. Plenty of battle scars and a whole lot of success.
11.
It's quite unusual to see Ronnie O'Sullivan ask the cue ball, or ask the referee to get the cue ball cleaned. He normally ignores kicks or bad contacts, but I think it's indicative of the fact that he's really ultra-focused now on getting this done.
Yeah. Just giving himself some more thinking time just to work things out. But it's going to have to be a bit of mileage on the cue ball here with the pink and black out of commission. He's being pushed here, he's being tested. And this is when he's at his best.
Yes, it was the first century from Gary Wilson that inspired O'Sullivan to produce
70.
A couple of frames of vintage magic to pull away to 8-5. And now Wilson has come up with his own brand of top draw snooker. And again, O'Sullivan unhappy with the state of the white. I think I've seen him ask the referee to clean the cue ball more times in this match than I've seen in the rest of the season put together.
Yeah.
Brendan Moore happy to do as he's told or asked.
Well, could you get in on the red that's just to above and the left of the black in such a way that you can stun into the red near the black? Then that'll really open things up. Now, I mean, this needs to come down a little bit further. I'm not sure if he's got there. He played on the one to the left corner. You're going to have to take the one to the right. There's nothing there. Play back for the blue. Now, he can play the same shot again. If he just drifts past the blue, that looks about perfect. Again, it's the red that's just above and to the left of the black. That's the one he's thinking about. Leave himself high. Then he can get the red out of the way from the black. Yeah, I think he's looked at the plant.
29.
It has to be made, but O'Sullivan fancies it.
Yeah, he should get that from there.
30. Things beginning to open up now for the Rocket.
He's working these well.
You haven't mismatched, by the way, on the other table in the last few minutes. Bit of a stalemate at the start of frame 7 between Stuart Bingham and Peter Ebden, although Bingham's now in with a 16-point lead at 4-2 up. Remember, we'll be joining that match, assuming O'Sullivan gets this one done in the fairly near future.
Now the pink will just squeeze in there. The best thing to do is to have a sip of water. It'll sit in the
36.
Chair. Now I'm back down for the blue again here, off this red. And he could go into the punch then. Could still play on the loose red. Ronnie knows, obviously, this is a great chance to put this match away.
37.
Now, what's going to do here? Will he punch into them or play on the loose one? Well, again, not the right angle to nudge the red away from the black. He's going to have to
42.
Play one here to get back for the blue. Oh, he's trying to get them open. It's not
43.
Bad. Well, that will do nicely. If it was just off straight, he could play on the one that's left of the pink. It's loose in the reds. Yeah, the one left of the pink would have been ideal.
Bags of action on the cue ball there.
Yeah. I think he's got some angle on this, Phil, actually. Yeah, just enough. Well, this opens up the pink.
Yes, is this the beginning of the end for Gary Wilson, who has given 48. A tremendous account of himself on his first ever appearance at the Crucible?
Yeah, I was about to say, if it is, then every credit to him.
I don't think many people will be asking 49. For a refund here at the Crucible after this match, whatever happens now.
Well, for me, second day in, it's been the best one so far.
And as you rightly mentioned, Mike, now Sullivan 54. Has been tested. He's been pushed today. But it looks as though he's going to come through with 55. Flying colours. And it's going to be fascinating to see just how far he can go. Remember Sean Murphy or Yan Bing Tao, another debutante, just 17 years of age, Yan, will play the winner. Advantage Murphy after session one this morning, leading 6-3. Gary Wilson now fearing the worst, just the hint 61. Of a shake of the head there of resignation. He could scarcely have 62. Played any better. He's tried to apply the pressure to O'Sullivan. And, well, he's done so, but this is the response of a champion. Sullivan grits his teeth. He's so close to the winning line, but not quite there. Although snookers, of course, are now required, and he is there now. 69. That will seal the deal for sure, if there was any lingering doubt. And finishing with a flourish. Can he release? Oh, my goodness. Well, suddenly we're into exhibition 75. Mode. What a match this has been. And suddenly the pockets are like buckets. 76. Well, Gary Wilson has made two centuries on debut. And he's won seven frames. No mean feat against the most naturally gifted player in the history of the game. But not quite enough to take out the Rocket.
How many times over the years have we seen Ronnie finish a match like this?
And all the more impressive given. And look at how pumped up he is. Look 85. At that. Well, it'll be nice to have a replay of his reaction there, because 87. I think this break means a lot to him. He was under pressure at the start of this frame, make no mistake. From 9-5 to 9-7, Wilson playing really well. And it looks as though he's going to respond with a clinching century break, his third of the match.
Well, it's great to see. He was up for this match. He's up for this tournament. Well.
Well, that's a shame. It looked like a century, but it's certainly a victory. And look at what it means to him. Well, if you were in any doubt at all about Ronnie O'Sullivan's desire to win a sixth world title, you won't be anymore. An extraordinary reaction from the Rocket. Damien Hirst, his good friend, watches on. And O'Sullivan is through to the round of 16, and he's done it in style. What a match it's been. Gary Wilson gave it everything on his debut. Terrific performance from him, but it's the Rocket through by 10 frames to 7. Really close run thing so far.
It has. Could have been all different yesterday. Let's not forget that Ronnie led 5-1. But how well did Gary do to come back into the session 5-4? And you can't discount this man against Ronnie this afternoon. You know, you, Ronnie knows he's got to play well.
Gary Wilson's a break.
This could be one to savour.
Three straight frames from the underdog. Can he make it four and tie this match at 5 apiece? It's worth noting, and we've already mentioned, Mike, that he made 8 centuries in qualifying, including the max. But the next best in terms of century makers in qualifying at Ponce Forge was 3 centuries. So that just shows how well he scored in those 3 qualifying rounds.
Just saw the pot success there. Yeah, 91 and 87. That's got to go up for Gary, of course. I mean, he's back in this, but he needs to get that percentage up. It's a good test for him this afternoon. And also, you know, so often the case, sometimes we wonder what sort of which Ronnie's going to turn up. We shall see this afternoon. If he plays, Ronnie plays, and obviously he's a very, very strong favourite. But.
Yeah, well, just the 150-plus break from Gary Wilson, as you see there. O'Sullivan making a 1-2-2 and 4 other contributions in excess of 50. O'Sullivan always scores heavily, win or lose. But the pressure is on this guy this afternoon, the Rocket. He's expected to win, of course. Mm. And that creates its own pressure.
Yeah, good shot there from Gary. I don't think he actually went for the pot, though. I think he meant to push it towards the middle, but cover it as well. Saw a little clip of Ronnie practicing earlier today, Phil, didn't we, with his great friend Damien Hirst.
Yeah, it's not bad when you can get a billionaire to pick the balls out of the pockets for you. Well, he might not quite be a billionaire, but he's not quite, he's not far off it, Damien Hirst.
I wonder how much he's charging Ronnie for that. Yeah, great friends. I'm sure that Damien is in the audience somewhere today. The problem, of course, here is the red near the middle pocket. But if this guy can get capture this opening frame, make it five apiece, you never know. Could be a very interesting afternoon. Well, I can suggest this might be going towards a re-rack, especially with that red there. Yeah, don't be surprised if it's called in a few shots' time.
Brandon Moore, our referee, I'm sure won't hang about if he feels as though the frame can't be progressed, and sure enough, there's already been agreement to start again.
Yeah, Ronnie's also the same. He doesn't like tip-tapping around like that, Phil, does he? So come on, let's just set them up. Let's get on with it.
Just their second meeting. Their first earlier this year in Berlin, German Masters. And it was a tight one. O'Sullivan won, but only 5-3. The packed Crucible Theatre. Looking forward to another afternoon of terrific snooker. Of course, keep you in touch with developments on the other table. Bingham and Ebden just getting underway.
Just look at some of the prize money here, Phil. Ronnie O'Sullivan just under, I think might have just gone over actually, the £9 million mark on the table. And 2.4 of that has come from here at the Crucible Theatre.
Won his first world title in 2001. His most recent back in 2013. Ronnie O'Sullivan, as Wilson watches on. And it's the longevity at the top that Ronnie O'Sullivan has produced, which is perhaps the most impressive aspect of his extraordinary career. Brilliant as they were, Steve Davis and Stephen Hendry had their success largely condensed to a single decade. And they had an awful lot of it. But O'Sullivan has been able to stay at the top for way longer.
And I think also, I'll just let Gary play this shot under the left eye striking, of course. Very similar to Graham Miles was the same. Hang on, that's a bonus. I was about to say, we can look at John Higgins as well, Phil. You know, he's playing some great snooker as well. And he's thinking, he was looking at Ronnie O'Sullivan a couple of years ago. He's thinking, well, if he can do it at 38, 39, why can't I? And it's sort of, John Higgins has got like his second wind.
Yeah, two big titles for the Wizard this season, including, of course, the Champion of Champions, which he won at the expense of O'Sullivan. Higgins underway tomorrow afternoon, by the way, against Martin Gould, and that's going to be a tough one. Gould is a very difficult draw for anyone.
Four.
Came through qualifying Martin. Of course, he won the German Masters last season. His maiden ranking title. That's a really tough obstacle for Higgins first up. But back here, Gary Wilson first in our first frame.
Five.
I think he's missed that. Oh, just thought it looked a little bit wide when it started out. It was only the pace.
12.
Looks fairly calm.
I think he was really relishing the opportunity to take on O'Sullivan. Clearly, he could scarcely have had a tougher draw, having come through qualifying.
13.
But on the eve of the championship, when, of course, we had our special 40-year anniversary here at the Crucible, he was asked by the BBC's Hazel Irvin how he felt about his first round opponent, and he was very much looking forward to it. I think he sees it as a privilege, the opportunity to play one of the all-time greats here.
Well, that's the attitude you've got to have. He's done the hard work to get here. Let's see how far you can go.
Well, that's a pretty decent split. Remember, this break was launched by a fluke. Can he make the most of it?
And we saw what happened last year with Ding Junhui coming through those qualifiers, Phil. We keep saying it, you know, the match fit. Steve Maguire's beaten a seed, Anthony McGill. You know, he was pretty sharp. Ronnie's coming in 21. Cold, as all the seeded players are. And I think they've got it right, because I remember used to play the qualifiers of the World Championship in September, the year before the actual event. That was ridiculous. But now, a few days before the Crucible, they've got it spot on.
Well, it adds to the drama, apart from anything else, doesn't it? With the qualifying rounds so close to the event, just heightens the anticipation and the expectation.
Well, you know, you do the hard work during the season. Like Ryan Day got in, you know, Mike Williams had won in China. He would have been here on the 16th, in the top 16. That's the reward for being here. But you know that you can get a bit sticky 20. Against a qualifier who's match fit.
Yes, ironically, Williams provisionally is now back in the 16, but of course it came too late for him, having just missed out by not winning the China Open against Selby. Pushed Selby close in the final, but then lost to Stuart Carrington in qualifying. But now provisionally, because of course points are coming off, there's a two-year 35. Cycle as regards the rankings, he's back up there. Well, you said it, Mike. He looks pretty calm, cool and collected, doesn't he? 68 points.
43.
Is what he's looking for here, assuming he continues to take blacks. And it will be looking like five apiece from 5-1 down. Not often that O'Sullivan loses four frames on the bounce to anyone. Although 44. He did lose 4-3 from 3-0 up earlier this season to Mark Davis, who didn't make it through qualifying.
Well, that's not quite a plan. They could go into them gently here and just nudge it towards the corner. Not too much pace. Just got to be careful. Hit that red bang on the nose on the pink spot. Always come off them. We know that the white always travels towards the corners. Well, he's got one to the centre here, which is tough.
50.
He's got a 50-point lead. I mean, he should close the shot.
Yes, discretion, the better part of valour, surely, in this situation.
No point taking anything on risky, is there? What's the point in that? I think he's trying to cut this one back near the black. Send the white down the table for safety. If he goes in, he's got control of the table once more. He's missed it, though, and he might have left it. Well, I think he's okay. I think he's got the cover with the brown. But a good start here for Gary Wilson in this opening frame of the second session.
Excuse me. Just hang on a sec, Ronnie. Come down.
Someone has said something they shouldn't have there. I'm not quite sure what it was, but you saw the reaction of both O'Sullivan and referee Brendan Moore, and I think he's seen his last snooker at this year's tournament.
This one here. Yeah, he needs to go.
Unnecessary, and the last thing we need, frankly. There's enough drama on the table without any required in the audience. So a slight hiatus while that gentleman is extricated. Early stages of the first frame on the other table, of course, Stuart Bingham with a 5-point lead over Peter Ebdon in frame one. And we're ready to go again.
Well, you can see that he has covered this red, but Ronnie playing the swerve here, he could easily pot this. Nope, got the wrong side. Trying to get it safe, though. Oh, Would you believe he could go past that red? Oh, that's Gary going back, I think. Unless Gary decides to move the red away. Just look at this, I can't believe there's room past that red. Oh. He could play away, move the red away from the pocket, actually, because if he puts Ronnie back, he could possibly pot it. Oh, well, there you go. Well, I think the white is a little bit more to the right as we look, actually, because, yeah, it needs to go probably an inch to the right. It wasn't that much, because Ronnie was coming the other side, I think.
Yeah, it's quite a bit wide of the mark at the moment. It needs to go as we look to the right.
He swerved around the right-hand side of the brown, Phil, not the left, so it's got to go, yeah. That's it's coming, like it. Coming around the right-hand side of the brown.
This is where the still frame is handy, and I think that's about right.
Yeah, within the circle, Ronnie. Okay.
All done. Are we playing the same shot again? Okay, too thin. Not bad.
Yes, I think he'll take that. Wilson has a 54-point lead, but if O'Sullivan can get back in, every chance he could pinch this frame.
Mobile phone went off there. Got to make sure that switched off. Good pace on the white here from Gary. Just got to keep the pressure on Ronnie in this opening frame of the session. Make it five apiece. Don't take any undue risks. This man has to do that to get himself back into this frame.
It's been a very consistent season for Ronnie O'Sullivan. Three major finals and, of course, the Masters title. But he lost the ranking finals. And the last one that he won was the 2016 Welsh Open, so he'll feel as though he's due another big ranking title, and none bigger than this one. It's funny, isn't it, Mike? By O'Sullivan standards, he'd probably feel a little bit frustrated at the way things have gone this season because he hasn't landed a ranking title. Then you look at the prize money he's trousered, £420,000.
Yeah, absolutely. I'll tell you what, though, he'd love to capture this one for the sixth time, wouldn't he? Don't worry, underneath, he'll be trying like a bear.
And that's something that cannot be doubted. He has given it absolutely everything in every match he's played this season, win or lose.
And he promised to play in more events this year, and he has done. But this is the real deal. This is the one he wants. He's done it five times before, of course.
The winner, remember, plays either Sean Murphy or Yan Bing Tao, with Murphy having finished their session earlier today with a 6-3 lead. O'Sullivan likes Selby in the top half of the draw, so they could potentially meet in the semi-finals, but there's a lot of snooker to be played before then.
Very close to that ground. Oh, well, Gary. Chance for Ronnie here to get right back into this frame. Won't be best pleased with that one.
Hit it almost full in the face here. Tell you that Stuart Bingham's on the cusp of taking the opener against Peter Ebdon.
Two. There's a bit to do here for Ronnie, but he's in with a chance. A couple of cannons and got these reds open. Look, sort of the colours in potable positions.
Nine.
Now, will he drift into the two reds here or screw into the three? Might be the three reds. Well, he's gone for the other two. Well, he's just caught them a little bit thinner than intended. That's not, he won't be best pleased with that one.
16.
And the expression confirms as much. Not the cannon he was hoping for.
No, he's looking for that quarter ball, actually. Still plenty on for him, though.
16.
Look at that, look at this one. Huh.
Well, it's an area of O'Sullivan's game that tends to go unnoticed at times because of the quality of his break building, but as a safety player, he's right up there with the best, and I'm sure his association with Ray Reardon back in the middle 90s, or rather the middle noughties, I should say, when he won his second world title, was instrumental in strengthening that side of his game. Reardon has actually said that he helped Ronnie to learn to love the defensive side of things, because previously he was very much about all-out attack.
Yes, and Ray also said that Ronnie was a very good listener.
They had a great rapport and they're still very close friends. Reardon, of course, who won this title for the very first time at the Crucible. First ever winner. Six times in all a champion, Reardon. One of the greats, unquestionably. One. Steve Davis's idol growing up. And many others, I'm sure. But this is another decent chance for O'Sullivan to get right back into this first frame of the final session.
Seven. Eight.
Spot the deliberate mistake. Of course, it was John Spencer who won the first one, wasn't it? Cliff Thorburn was his victim, I believe.
Yep, think so.
15.
Cliff went on to win it in 80. Reardon won it in 78.
60.
The last of his six titles. Griffiths, 79. And Davis, the first of his six in 81. What a rich history, this great venue.
22.
Possesses...
23.
This time I ever saw the World Championship, Phil, was back in 76. It was at Withenshaw Forum in Manchester. And Ray Reardon beat 29. Alex Higgins there. Played really well. And then I went to the Crucible Theatre in 77 for the first time. Loved it.
30.
Yes, Mike Watterson, snooker promoter, was the man who brought this tournament to the Crucible, but it was actually his wife Carol who recommended the venue. And my goodness, how inspired was that decision?
Ronnie here then can drop in behind this final red, just eight points behind. Well, they're all there, and I'll tell you what, this will be a bit of a blow here to Gary Wilson if he loses his frame, because start that he made in it, and he could have tightened things up, and he missed a couple of chances, and he could easily lose it from here now.
Running on the stretch rather here, but that was beautifully cued.
38.
So scores level.
He's gone too far, I think, Phil. The green won't pass the yellow. He's played on the yellow. It won't go, so that could be end of break, just dropping behind the green for the snooker. He's going to have to wait for another chance.
Ronnie O'Sullivan, 38.
Well, 38, but he wanted to be on the yellow there.
Yeah, you saw that little shake of the head from O'Sullivan. He expected to polish off the frame there, as it is. Scores level with the colours remaining.
Just bounced the cue ball into the cushion there to get the angle. He nearly potted the yellow in the middle. It would have been nicer on the green as well. So, which way is this opening frame of this final session then, or second session, going to go?
opening frame of the deciding session on a knife edge.
The blue is a good target to get in behind. Not this time. I wonder if Gary will take this on. Could probably play up and down with the yellow. Just wait. Could have easily lost his frame a couple of minutes ago if Ronnie had landed on that yellow. Yeah, I think that was the right shot to play at this stage of the frame. It's all the fives and the fours, Phil.
Yes, a certain symmetry to the scoreboard. O'Sullivan now in his 42nd year, but still in terrific shape, physically and, of course, mentally these days. Said ahead of this tournament that he enjoys it more than ever now, because whereas in the past, and he's played one there, hasn't he? He was up and down. Now he's much more on an even keel and can enjoy it more as a result.
And this is tough to hit. Going to come off this left-hand cushion with a lot of side here. Just look at this, worth the replay. As long as he avoided the double kiss, we knew what was coming. Brilliant.
Foul on the miss. Ronnie O'Sullivan, 6.
Well, I think that's going back.
Okay, a little bit that way.
It's very difficult to get anywhere near this yellow. The brown is in the way as well. If it wasn't there, if it's on its spot, it'd be much easier. But he's got to try and manufacture an angle. Well, I'm not sure going this way that it's on. Nope, pink again. Guess what?
Oh, the miss.
That's going back. Could be a free ball, this.
Ronnie O'Sullivan, 6. Free ball.
Not sure that's going to change anything. No, back it goes. Handy points here, though, for O'Sullivan.
Don't move the yellow about there. Just a fraction there, yeah. Yeah.
Yep, Ronnie will just stay in his chair, take the points.
Ronnie.
Again, I'm not sure that he's on from this angle. Nope.
Foul and a miss.
Guess what?
Ronnie O'Sullivan, 6. Free ball.
Well, he's got to be careful here, Wilson, because these points are mounting, and as you can see, only 27 on the table, obviously, 18 behind now.
Well, imagine if he hits the pink another couple of times. He'll need a snooker. Nope, I don't think it's on. Oh, dear me, now then, there's a difference. Well, I don't know whether Ronnie will put it back this time.
Okay, so 24 the difference. He only needs the yellow.
Yeah, good spot, Phil. Oh, this has been a disaster. He had a great start to the frame. Towards the end of the frame, it's been a total disaster for Gary Wilson.
But what a terrific snooker that Ronnie O'Sullivan laid. It's one in the frame, surely. It was very tough for Wilson to find a way out of it. So it's looking like O'Sullivan from more than 50 points adrift is going to win this opening frame and move two clear again.
Yeah, just not this green as well. Don't worry about the brown, of course. The green to really make sure. Oh, well, there's a little bit of light at the end of the tunnel here.
2.
The difference is 26. There are 25 there.
Should be over now, either to the middle or to the corner. Well, this could be massive, Phil, in the context of the match, because we know it should have been 5-all. We think it's about to go 6-4, and we know what Ronnie's like as a front runner. He could be off into the distance.
It's a blow, certainly, for Wilson, who had that very healthy lead. Had a chance to get back in, missed a long red.
Ronnie O'Sullivan, 3.
So 29 now, the difference. He needs a couple of snookers.
Yeah, and you can't blame him for playing on here. This is a big, big frame. Yeah, so Ronnie's just asking for the brown to be clean. He had it, actually got a kick on the on his last shot.
He's going to get the white cleaned. No, I thought he was going to get the white cleaned as well.
He could be in trouble here, behind the black or the pink. Well, he should have been. Well, that's not clever. You won't miss this. It's about to go 6-4, and it could have been 5 apiece. Well, didn't expect that. It's over now. Well, Gary doing the gentlemanly thing there, allowing Ronnie to win the frame on his shot. But he'll be disappointed that he's lost this opening frame, considering the start he made.
4.
Yes, Wilson had a 50-point lead. And he had one or two other chances later in the frame. But it was the brilliant snooker that Ronnie O'Sullivan laid, which was the pivotal moment in this frame. Well,
Ronnie O'Sullivan, 4.
Gary Wilson comes back to the table. Tall order now, to put it mildly. Particularly now he's potted the blue, which 5. He didn't have much opportunity to keep out of the pocket, to be fair.
Well, the black is in a good position, but it's a long way back. I don't think Ronnie can pot this. He can see it, but I'm not sure if he can pot it to the middle. Oh, he could even try to, well, he tried to the corner, so he could see more of the pink than I thought.
Wilson requires 3 snookers here with just pink and black remaining.
Nah, it's not going to happen. Can't see it happening. Ronnie's too cute for that. Perhaps against a rookie in the qualifiers. Not on this stage.
Unorthodox. So it's Ronnie O'Sullivan who takes the opening frame, and it was the snooker he laid that made the difference there. O'Sullivan extends his lead and moves to within 4 of victory.
Keep the noise down, please.
He's
thank
leading
you.
Gary Wilson by 6 frames to 4.
I think here, though, Phil, I think you've got to say that this is a must-win frame for Gary Wilson if he's got any chance of winning this match. He's played a good safety here, but if he goes 7-4 behind, look at this, played one. If he goes 7-4 behind, it's going to get sticky for him. So, but if he can put this on the board, you know, he's back in this. It's a long way to go, number 10, but like I said, Ronnie puts 2 quick frames together here, and then that's tough. Well, it was Ronnie's great snooker that won in the last frame. Now, can Gary take advantage here? This is excellent safety snooker behind the green that's given him this chance. Let's not forget, yesterday he was 5-1 down, came back to 5-4.
One.
He can do it again.
He's already proved his resilience, hasn't he? Terrific win over Michael White in qualifying. Comprehensive one as well, 10-3.
Yeah, Michael's no slouch and he's been playing well of late. I think he's just got there. Yep, and this left hand red.
Six.
It's a gimme though.
Made it look easy.
Seven.
Nice angle. Doesn't have to go full-blooded into the pack here. He can just come off the left-hand side and that open red will push it towards the corner. So a gentle cannon. Just nudge the left-hand side of the pack. Could go in full to the pink. Doesn't have to. Just a nice, soft, accurate cannon here. Well, downward strike, and I think he's going in full-blooded. Oh. Caught them well, could have been better.
Well, he's very unlucky there. If he's not landed on anything, he couldn't have hit that much better than he did.
12.
Super attacking shot, just off the apex of the pink.
Just wonder if there's one to the right centre, Phil, and he can come back for the black. Yeah, I think he's okay, actually. Worked out okay. Wow, what a chance is this?
13.
Former world under 21 champion, Gary Wilson. Made a living as a taxi driver, of course, in years gone by. But he's 20. Discovered that he's a rather handy snooker player.
Well, the meter's running here.
Number of tournaments and the prize money available 21. These days. Wilson, who's still only 31, could make hay over the next decade.
Doesn't need any direction around the snooker table either.
And this is already a good response to losing the opening frame.
28.
Because he was well ahead in that one, and it could have demoralised him. But he's got straight back on with the job here.
Yes, this is not landed ideally. He's going to pop this and just run off another red here. Unless he's going through the gap for the blue. But he's got the reds open. This is a great chance. 29. Played that well. Just thinking this could be a treat here this afternoon, Phil, and that could be punch and counterpunch. There again is the
34
scoring sidebar. 69 points required. Disappointed 35. To lose the last frame. He's got a chance to do something about it here, though.
Yes, and just send a message to Ronnie O'Sullivan that he's not going anywhere. He's going to give it everything in a bid to cause a big upset. Bingham still 1-0 up on Ebden, by the way, on the other table, although 40. Peter Ebden has a 40-point lead in the second frame.
41.
Ronnie O'Sullivan found himself in trouble at the start of this one. Left Wilson a red, and this is the result.
48.
Well, I did say last frame, 49. Gary looked really relaxed and calm and whatever, and the disappointment, of course, losing the frame, but just capture this one, and I'm sure you'll feel better.
Fifty-seven.
I think his heart missed a beat there.
Do you know, I think he got a slight kick there. He just took it offline nearly enough to rattle it. I think it just was a little bit of a kick. That was as well. That's why he's short on the red.
But this red, 64. And another high-value colour. And it should be one apiece for the afternoon session. And the gap reduced to 6-5. That'll do nicely. And how well has Gary Wilson taken these?
Good response.
It's now his highest break of the match.
Well, the thing is, at the end of the day, Phil, we know he knows how well he's played to get here to the Crucible. We keep talking about it, what, 8 centuries, including a maximum. He knows he's playing well. He knows he's playing the most talented, gifted player we've ever seen. But, you know, don't get here and think, well, I'm not going to play, because he knows he's in good form.
Yes, in the past, I think Ronnie O'Sullivan has beaten a lot of opponents before they shook hands at the start of the first frame. His reputation going before him, but I think for Wilson, he was going to always embrace this opportunity. Relish the challenge of taking on one of the best ever. And he's giving O'Sullivan quite a match here.
And this has been a superb break. Really has. Not really in any trouble. As soon as he went into the pack, split them, yes, he managed to finish on the one to the middle. But since then, he's been in full 86. Control. Would be nice to see a century.
Would be the 18th of the season for him. Bear in mind, he made just 3 last season. Currently at 59 in the world. He has been as high as 32. That was back in 2015. But he's back on the rise again.
Thank you. That was clever. Just clipping the other red, bringing it into the open.
87.
Special moment this will be for Gary Wilson, the first Crucible century on his debut.
93.
Well, he could set the high break here. Ronnie's got it at 122. That won't stand. There's 135 on. I don't think that will stand, but yeah.
Well played. 100. Terrific stuff. A great response to losing the first frame, which he looked like winning. And showing that mentally he is rock solid. And Ronnie O'Sullivan still has plenty to do to win this first round match. A century from the debutant as he closes the gap to 6-5. For the qualifier, but he's got plenty still to do to get the win that's expected of him. Well, you saw from his reaction, he wasn't thrilled with that safety. You know, a little bit lucky there, could have left that red.
Well, we think this is a marathon, Phil, 17 days. Just looking through the lists and back in like 1947, 48.